DJ Benny James, welcome to the podcast. It's a pleasure to be here, an honor as always. Thank you for pressing play. Thank you for joining me. Today's show is number 94. Wow, we're getting up there, close to 100. And it is Soul Speaks, number 3. And if you've listened to my podcast before, you know that Soul Speaks means I have a guest. And no exceptions today, I have a very, very special guest, Dr. Hall. How you doing?
I'm doing well. How are you?
I'm good. We're here. We woke up this morning and it's sunshine. Very windy, but it's sunshine and we're here. Thank you so much for joining me. Cynthia is from Free Haven Farms. And I'm really excited to talk to you because my podcast and the radio station that I started up is all about love, positivity. It's about health of the mind, the body, the spirit. And I've just got so many questions for you because you have created this whole farm and the teaching, and I want to talk to you all about that. So let's talk about how you got into this whole thing in the first place. Why? Why did you get into farming? It seems like a crazy thing to get into.
Yeah, it definitely is a crazy thing. So my husband started growing food when we first got married and had our first child. So I was still in graduate school and we didn't have a lot of money. So right. It was really just to offer some organic produce for our family that we couldn't afford because it was really expensive. And from there, my husband really got involved in urban agriculture when we moved to Philly from Atlanta, and some of the issues with food access and food justice, especially in inner city communities that don't have the same access
right.
to fresh fruits and vegetables. So he started working on a farm in Philly, and you know, one thing led to another, and we got our own land. So we started our own farm, and I've been adding to that vision as a scientist. So we'll get into that as well.
Right. Well, we first met a while back. My wife was selling jewelry at a market and you guys were selling your fresh produce at a market. And that's how we met and we connected. I was playing some music and you were like, man, I love your music and you love my wife's jewelry. So we got talking and vibing and yeah, it was just a good connection right off the bat. And I would love to come to Free Haven Farms and find out more. So the next time we do this, I was telling you, we should do it. I come down there. I'll set up in the middle of a field somewhere and we'll just do it.
Yes, that would be amazing.
And we got to get your husband on the mic next time. Let me get his name. See if I can get his name right. Micaiah, is that right?
Yes.
Oh, right. Yep. Okay. So, Micaiah, we're missing you today. Sorry you couldn't be with us. But anyway, he had to stay at the farm and take care of stuff, right?
Absolutely, yeah.
So I was reading a little bit on your website, and it said that George Washington Carver is your hero and inspiration. Can you talk a little bit more on that?
Oh, yeah, definitely. So the first thing is that George Washington Carver was a scientist and a farmer, and that really encompasses who we are, my husband and I. He's the farmer, I'm the scientist. So we sort of bring that same energy to Free Haven Farms and really the work that Carver did in the South in the early 20th century. He saved agriculture in the U.S., but particularly he was interested in helping Black farmers because the whole industry was surrounded around cotton. And that was tearing the soil down. It was, you know, just terrible environmentally as well as socially for that community. And so he switched, you know, everyone knows George Washington Carver for peanuts.
Right.
But it was actually sort of a more scientific aspect because peanuts are nitrogen fixers. So they built up the soil. But he kind of had this whole, you know, being sustainable. So because peanuts were good to plant as well as soybeans, he came up with a lot of discoveries around peanuts. He actually didn't discover peanut butter, which is kind of like we're taught that falsely in school, but it was more he developed a lot of inventions from peanuts and from soybeans. So his spirit is really what drives what we do at Free Haven Farms, kind of taking what we have. We always tell people to grow wherever you live, you can grow, whether you're an apartment or you have a house, you have a little bit of soil, no soil.
Well, we definitely want to talk about that because I'm sure a lot of people are going to be inspired by what you guys are doing. But like to do stuff at home, potting plants, if you've got a little piece of land in the back of your garden or the front or whatever. So we'll talk about that more. I'm going to play a song that I don't know if you've ever heard before by a gentleman called Jarrod Lawson. I've played him before on my show, but I'm going to play it again because I think it suits this show. It's called All That Surrounds. And he's basically just talking about nature and how amazing nature is. So I think this is a good start to the show. Enjoy, everybody.
Covered with love from above. Ooh. 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 Well, I could stand out here for hours being christened by showers, but the day is slipping away and I ain't even begun to play. So I stroll to the square to join the pack, keg in the sack. The sky is three different shades of gray and I don't mind to say it's my favorite kind of day. I don't know what's coming. Elegant light silently dances. The wind whispered in my ear, and quick as it came, it disappeared. But I heard it loud and clear. So many people are unaware of what it is they have to share, and the value therein is not a thing to be measured by men. Oh, I don't know what's going on.
Once again, sounds of the Jarrod Lawson. Love this guy. I was lucky enough to see him in the UK. It's amazing. Very, very talented. I got some Erykah Badu next for you. And I saw a posting with you with Erykah Badu. Are you guys friends or something?
Yeah, we actually met through Instagram, believe it or not.
Okay.
She started following our page, Free Haven Farms. And she came into town and we went to the show and we got to meet her and connect. And she's just amazing. She's so dope.
Yeah, she's just on another level, man. Amazing.
Yeah, she really is.
So talk about the farm a little bit, because I know you have loads of different things going on at the farm. You have classes, you have workshops, you have stuff, youth science clubs. Talk more about the farm so we can find out more about what you guys do.
So yeah, we do a lot on the farm. So of course we started just growing produce. That was the main thing. And We did farmers markets a couple years ago when we met you guys. We were doing 5 markets a week. It was just, you know, insane.
Wow, that's a killer.
Yeah. You know what the farmer market.
I know. You get up early. You got to get up really crack of dawn. And my wife was like, come on, you can do this. I'm like, I hate you.
Yes.
She's like, get a crack of dawn. You get there. You got to set up all the tent. You got to set up everything. And then you got to hope that people come.
Yes.
Right.
Yo, it's crazy. So we were doing that heavy. But, you know, at the farmers market, we really got a lot of questions, and we saw the need for education, and so we developed relationships with schools. So we were working at a school, putting in gardens and teaching the youth all about gardening and science and all the lessons you get from the garden. And so, man, you know, COVID was just crazy last year.
Yeah.
Caused us to think about other aspects of our business, because farmers markets in the beginning like weren't going to be a thing. So that's where we really started pushing our classes and started pushing some products we were making from things we're growing on the farm. So my husband makes the world famous fire sauce. So it's a hot sauce from these crazy peppers that
like
he
ghost
grows.
Peppers or
yes.
Something like that. Okay.
Yeah. So he makes the hot sauce, and then from there we started doing. I make muffins when we have blueberries in the summer, and we started doing these kale chips. I make tea from the herbs that we grow. So really, just like developing a lot of farm products. And then, like you said, the classes, the workshops. We have our first workshop on the farm tomorrow. That's
wow.
Why Micaiah can't be here, because he's like ripping and running, getting right. Everything ready. And we do Youth Science Club on the weekends. I meet with them on Zoom, but we're going to have our summer camp back on the farm this summer.
Wow.
So we
okay.
Have kids that come out, and we're just exploring nature and gardening and science and finding bugs and tracking the deer that try to come through and eat our produce, but some good lessons there. So
right. And how long has this been going on now, you said, for the farm?
We've had the farm since 2017, so this is like our fourth season, or maybe our fifth season. But yeah,
right. One other thing I want to talk about real quick before we go to some more music. You have a merch store as well, which is cool. People can actually get stuff. But what I was really intrigued with as well was the fresh box delivery. So can you talk about those two things real quick before we go to some more music?
Yeah, definitely. So we do have a lot of merch. We have everything from like our hoodies and our hats, the stuff that we tag with our Free Haven Farms, to our kale chips and the tea, the fire sauce that we make. So everything that we make, we have on our site. And then the fresh box, that's like a CSA. So, you know, where you purchase a share of the farm and
oh.
You get, but, you know, again, because of COVID and because of Instagram and social media, we were getting folks following us from California. Hey, can I get some produce?
Got it.
To support our message and what we do. So we started shipping, you know, nationwide. And
wow.
So we started that last year. And, you know, I send out a recipe every week, a newsletter, and it just kind of grew to be a little bit more than just a CSA. Like, we really know our customers. But we were going up to Brooklyn every week last year, going to Philly. Of course, we were in Jersey at the market. And so, yeah, that's what the Fresh Box is.
Wow.
Just giving people that fresh produce every week.
So when do you sleep?
Oh, my gosh. Right. And we've got 3 kids.
But you look so great. You're all put together. You're like, how do you get time?
You know, and yoga. So I've been
and
doing
yoga as well. Yeah, we're going to talk about that more as well, because that's the whole, you know, mind, body, spirit thing, right? But let's get to some Erykah Badu before we get to some more chatting. I'm going to play the apple tree for you, because obviously
I like to dedicate this to all the creative.
It's about growing stuff, right? The creative.
I have some food in my bag for you.
What's up, Erykah?
Not that edible food. The food you eat? No. I have some food for thought. Since knowledge is infinite, it has infinitely fell on. It was a stormy night, you know, the kind where the lightning strikes. And I was hanging out with some of my artsy friends. Ooh, you, you. The night was long, the night went on. We were cooling out through the break of dawn. Incense was burning, so I'm feeling right. I see, I picked my friends like I pick my fruit. And Gaye told me that when I was only you, I don't walk around trying to be what I'm not. I don't waste my time trying to get what you. It pleases me, cause it can't please you. And that's why I do what I do. My soul flies free like a willow tree. Do we, do we, do we? And if you don't wanna be down with me, you don't wanna be from my apple tree. And if you don't wanna be down with me, then you don't wanna be from my apple tree. And if you don't wanna be down with me, then you don't wanna be from my apple tree.
Badu. I was lucky enough to see her a couple years ago DJing, believe it or not, in Hawaii. Did you know she DJs?
Yes, I've seen that. Yo, she's so dope.
She is dope. I must confess, though, her singing is a lot better than her DJing. Sorry, Erykah. No, I really wanted to see her sing live and she was DJing. You know, as a DJ, right? It's you want to hear something different than what you do, but she was dope. Nevertheless, it was just amazing to be that close to her and just feel her presence. So you gave me a gift. Thank you very much. Nobody comes with a gift, but you came with a gift. Bearing gifts. I love this. And this is, what is it? What is it called?
So it's my husband's first self-published book. It's called Farmalosophy.
Farmalosophy. I love it.
Yes. And it's so appropriate. Micaiah is a wordsmith. So
right.
Definitely like makes up words and things like that. So the book is all about the philosophies of growing food in the farm that you can apply to your own life. So it's a lot of like sayings, and then he sort of explains how they can apply to your life. So, for example, he wakes up every day, and this has been since we were dating back in, you know, early 2000s. He says, new dawn, it's a new day. So he always says these little sayings like that. And so the book explains how every day is a new beginning and every day is a blessing. You have a chance to start over. So it's kind of just like a motivational book. And but it talks about growing food, too.
And he's a pharmacist.
Yes.
Not a farm, not like a chemist pharmacist, but
yes,
a farm
with an F.
That's dope. So does he do poetry as well?
Not like formally, but, you know, child of the late 70s, 80s. So grew up in hip hop. And so a lot of freestyling. And yeah, he's amazing on the mic just off the top. Like he used to write back in the day, but since I've known him, doesn't really write or do poetry or anything, but he can just, you know, while we're working on the farm, we always have music playing. So that's why it'd be great for you to come out and DJ.
Yeah, I've got to come out sometime and spin. You know, I've said that if you have any special events, I'd be more than happy to come and support what you guys are doing because I think it's amazing. Especially on a day like this when it's nice and sunny. And well, it's actually going to be a bit humid today. But yeah. Anyway, let's get to some Bob Marley real quick. This is not one of your ones. This is one of my ones, but we'll play this one first.
If it's a new feeling. starts a new day.
Picking up. Are you picking up now?
Jala.
Wicked. Bob Marley and the Wailers, of course. Positive vibration. That's what we like to bring, positive vibration. If you're listening to this on lovesoulradio.net, thank you for joining us. It's all about the positivity.
We've
got a special guest here, Cynthia Hall, Dr. Cynthia Hall from Free Haven Farms. Thank you so much for joining me.
Thanks for having me.
You're most welcome. And I tell you what, Bob Marley, man, his music, man, he just, no wonder he was like a global phenomenon, right? His messages. And I think he just sung from here, just really connected with people.
Absolutely.
Now I see the dreads. So is that just a style or are you a Rasta? What's going on here?
So, yeah, I mean, I don't give myself any labels.
Okay.
So just to stay clear of that. But no, man, Bob Marley definitely was a huge, huge influence. And, you know, I started my locks back in 94. So it was really before the style and the fad and all of that. And it right. was my oldest brother, really, you know, he locked his hair and got into Bob Marley. He was in college and used to just bring home tapes because it was the 90s of Bob Marley. And so I just listened and absorbed it, and I was yeah. reading books. So I was definitely, especially even in my 20s and into Rasta culture. But the music, you know, has just stayed with me, you yeah. know what I mean? Because of the message and the vibe, and yeah. it's universal, you yeah. know, and it just definitely speaks the message that, you know, resonates with me about yeah. one love and, yeah. you know, loving everyone, respecting the earth, just a lot of messages that he preached, but just even reggae music in general.
Yeah.
Just,
there's something about yeah. reggae music and obviously Bob Marley as well. When I used to live in Hawaii, I think Bob Marley is one of the most played artists on the island. And there's something about being on an island and that reggae music. Come on, you don't need anything more than that. I mean, how you can't be unhappy listening to reggae music. You
That's
know what I'm
the
saying?
Thing. That's the thing. It's the joy.
Yeah, it's the joy. It's just so much love in it. But we're going to play one of your tunes next before we go back to talking about the farm. This is a Marvin Gaye track you chose. Mm-hmm. And man, this is one of the ones you don't really hear. It says, soon I'll be loving you again. So why do you choose this one?
Well, first of all, you gave me this task because it became a task of choosing these five songs.
Picking five songs. That's what I do for all my guests. I pick five songs. Like, how can I pick five songs? But it's ones that inspired you in some way or changed your direction in life or something, yeah. you know, and they just really meant something to you at that time. So yeah. why did you choose this one?
So I got introduced to the album I Want You back in, I don't know, I was in grad school. And at that time, just because I lived by myself, I was working on my PhD, and just a lot of time by myself to be introspective. And this was one of the albums that I could just listen to straight through, and it just would like take me my mind. Right. So even though it's about romantic love, I kind of looked at it as self-love too. And so doing a lot of exploration of myself and learning about who I was, I used to do yoga to this CD all the time. It was just one of my favorite music to listen to while I practice yoga. And that song in particular, I don't know, it's just, I love it, man. It just, you know, when I make a playlist, it's on there. Right. So,
and it takes you back to that time.
It takes me back to that time, absolutely.
Okay. So we're going to play that one by Marvin Gaye. And like I said, this is one you don't really hear. So this is perfect for my podcast right here, because you know I always like to play the B-sides. Marvin Gaye.
I thought you here with me. If you could only see how much I love you, you'd want to trust me. Time, you know, so I made up my mind. Come on, baby.
love it. Why don't you hear that on the radio?
I don't know. Those background vocals are ridiculous.
I know. His voice, man. He's got such a range. I think the closest to him in the modern era, in my opinion, is Maxwell.
Yes.
Because Maxwell can go high, low, low.
The live performance.
Oh, come on. That's what it is. That unplugged? Dangerous. I got my friend back in the UK, Justine. What's up, Justine? When she sees that, she's like, everybody just leave me alone. I go watch Maxwell. She loves him. Anyway, let's get back to this questions real quick. I want to go back to that thing about you saying, you know, if you got a little piece of land, even if you got like a planting box, you can grow your own stuff. Obviously, you want people to come to your farm, but you want people to take care of themselves at home as well, sustain themselves at home. Yes. Can you talk a little bit about that?
Yeah, it's really, really powerful to grow your own food and to eat something that you've grown yourself. And, you know, it's really the connection that you have with your food when you're growing it that I think we've lost touch with, you know, as like human beings, right? That we don't have the connection with food that we used to, you know, it's very intimate eating, you know, this is why some pray before you eat, because it's, you know, it's a spiritual thing. This food is going to become your body.
Right.
Right. In a very like scientific, biochemical kind of way. But then there's like all the essence of that food is going to enter your body. So when you're taking care of it, when you planted the seed and you water it and you trim it and you're weeding and, you know, you go through this whole process, it's like this bell pepper is like, I love you. You know?
Right. That makes sense. It's like it's your child, right? Because you planted the seed, it grew, you took care of it.
Yeah.
And then you killed it.
And then you eat your child.
And then you ate your child. No, seriously.
No,
but I mean, you are what you eat, right?
Yes.
And, you know, I can only talk for myself, right? I'm 52. I'm only 52 this year, I think. And I have sleep apnea. I'm a little bit overweight, just about 20 pounds overweight, maybe more. You know, health conditions, right? And my wife is an amazing cook. And but we would love more organic stuff in our lives, just raw plant-based foods, mm-hmm. Because I just really believe in that and how it makes you feel lighter and healthier. Can you talk a little bit about the health benefits, really?
Yes.
Mind, body, spirit of just eating more healthy. And then the second part to that is it's so expensive sometimes.
Yes.
So people prefer to just go to the drive-in and get a $1 burger.
Right.
But let's speak about the health benefits first.
Yeah. So when you're eating things that are fresh, you're maximizing the nutrients. So you're getting all the nutrients that are attended in that spinach or that bell pepper, that tomato. You're able to absorb them when you're eating it fresh. So if you don't have the ability to grow your own food, you don't have the time. That's why we have our fresh box, why we go to farmers markets. But when you're able to go in your backyard or go to the container on your balcony and pick that tomato off of the plant and then you eat it, It's within seconds, like the food is still alive. Again, maybe you're eating your babies, but it's no, the food is still alive. Like it's almost, you know, pulsating with life. So you're getting all of those nutrients, like stuff starts to degrade in the plant within seconds after you harvest it. And we do things, we put it in water immediately. And, you know, so we bring it to market, it's still fresh. But that's why we say we can't give you that experience of picking it and then eating it. It's a whole nother level. So even as a foodie, which is for me where all this comes from, because I just love to eat and I want it to taste good.
Me too.
So like you eat a tomato off the vine and that stuff in the store, you're like, what? That's not a tomato. That's not what this is supposed to taste like.
Right. And not only taste, but look as well. I used to live in the north of Sweden for a while, and the fruit and vegetables there were very, very different in the local markets. They didn't even look the same. Everything was kind of misshaped and looked different color.
Yeah.
Even the pork was like really red. I'm like, pork's white, isn't it? And they're like, no, this isn't like natural pork.
Right.
Like, and all the apples were like different shapes and everything. Everything didn't look perfect like
exactly.
It looks in the supermarket. So looks as well. I mean, it's crazy.
Yeah, you can experiment with things. I always say, you know, especially to the kids, that when you grow your own food, you have a garden. It's an experiment. Every year, it's a new experiment. So just try stuff. We try different varieties, black tomatoes and purple peppers. And we do all sorts of, you know, exotic things. But you buy a pack of seeds, it's $5.
Right.
And you're going to have a supply for the whole year. So now going to the price thing.
Yes.
You know, it is expensive. And it isn't so much that the organic produce is expensive at the store. It's that the other stuff is too cheap.
The other stuff is too cheap. The highly processed stuff.
The highly processed stuff, because it isn't real food. It could sit on the shelf for months.
Yeah.
So,
yeah.
Of course, it's only $1 for a bag of chips, yeah, before a bag of potatoes is $5. How does that make sense?
Right, right. And my friend who used to work at Whole Foods in Hawaii, he said that when he eats something that has more nutrients in it, he said it's actually, he feels like he's full up.
You're fuller.
And he's full for longer.
Yes.
So people that are getting that fast food burger or whatever, 20 minutes later, you're hungry again. Because,
yes,
there's no nutrients in it.
That's right.
So although it's cheaper, it's not going to last long, and absolutely, it's not doing any good for your body, right?
Right. It's going to tear you down. It's like you pay now or pay later.
Right.
And so that's, you know, one of the things, again, early on, we used to spend our whole check. We used to call Whole Foods whole check. We used to spend our whole check on buying food because that was the most important thing. You know, I was in grad school. We didn't have health insurance. So it was like, don't get sick.
Right.
You better not get sick.
Right.
You know, and so it's always, you know, taking the preventative measures, and that's what growing your food is. And so it can be cheap. If you supplement whatever you can, again, if it's just your herbs or you just grow maybe one thing, tomatoes, or you're able to grow a variety of things,
right,
you know.
All right. Well, we'll talk a little bit more. I want to talk about consultations that you guys do, mm-hmm, and the soil tests and all that kind of stuff. And although you guys are based in New Jersey, people can go to your website and find out more about what you guys do and learn from your website. What's the website again?
So our website, we have freehaveneducationalfarms.com. And that's like, you know, our informational website. And then we have also a Shopify store if you search for Freehaven Farms. If you follow us on Instagram and find Freehaven Farms, it links directly to our store, and that's where you'll be able to buy the merchandise and,
yeah,
and all that stuff.
Well, what I'll do is I'll put the links in the podcast information as well on Facebook and on my other site, so people can just click on there. But people listening to this, I have people listening to my podcast from all over the world and on the radio as well. It's international. So obviously they might not be here in New Jersey, but
right,
I'm sure there's things that they can find out right there that can be really helpful for them to live,
absolutely,
a healthier lifestyle.
Definitely. We ship all over the world. We've had,
wow,
books and seeds. We can't ship our produce overseas, but we've shipped our merchandise to Sweden and to the UK, and
okay,
sent books over there. So, and then we do consultations. We help people get started with growing their own food, and we do it through Zoom. So again, we can do it anywhere. You know, we got to link up the time zone,
there,
but we can link up.
Okay.
So yeah,
okay,
absolutely. We're global too. We're region.
See. International.
That's right.
All right, we're going to play another song here. We're going to go to some Four Tops, go back to that old school soul.
Baby,
this is called The Way Nature Planned It.
Girl, all my
mixing up the flavors for you today. That's a classic soul track, Four Tops. We got a little bit of hip-hop today, we got a little bit of reggae, even got a little bit of jazz for you today. So mixing up the flavors for you today.
Yes.
You enjoying yourself?
Oh, I'm having a blast.
As you can see, this is my church, right? I go into my own little zone and I'm like, I'm gone already.
That's about where I am too.
Especially my wife makes me some food, gets me a little drink. I turn the lights down. I'm like, okay. I'm in like heaven right now.
Yes, vibes.
So we're going to play another one of yours right now, Minnie Riperton. I like Minnie Riperton, but I never heard this one before. Reasons.
Yes.
Why do you choose this one?
Oh, man. This song is amazing. First of all, yes, Minnie Riperton, one of the greatest voices ever.
Yeah.
Her range, that note that she hits is just
crazy.
Famous. But this song, someone put this on a mixtape back when I was in grad school, and just like me and music, I got my first iPod. So I listened in the lab. I used to be in the lab for hours and hours and listening to music. But this song, when you hear the lyrics, it's so inspirational. It's such a beautiful song. She's got that free spirit, that West Coast vibe that I love. And so the song is just dope vibes. But her message, you know, like the reasons why she does what she does, you know, and it's just to inspire people. And she gave so much of herself, you know what I mean? She died so young, but her spirit just is really, really beautiful. So,
okay. Yeah. Okay. Reasons. Mini Riperton, never heard it before until now. Love it. Her voice, that note that she reaches, crazy.
Absolutely incredible.
What was her most famous song? Loving You?
Loving You.
Loving You. Love that song. Oh my God. Every time I hear it.
Yes.
So, I know you got kids. You said you have three kids?
Yes.
How old are your kids?
They are 10, 13, and my son will be 15 in a couple of weeks.
Let's give them a shout out. What's their names?
Satafa is my son.
Satafa.
Yes. Adia, my 13-year-old daughter. And then the youngest is Araminta or Minty.
Minty, I love it.
Yes.
And do they help out? Is it a whole family affair?
Oh, yeah, definitely. You know, when they were younger, they were always in the garden. And, you know, we lived on the farm for several years, so it was just in their backyard, and they were always involved. And so now we live a couple of miles away, kind of outgrew the space. And, you know, I got teenagers and preteens, so they need money.
Right.
So now if we lure money, you know, mm-hmm. a wage, mm-hmm. then we can yeah. get them on the farm. But yeah, yeah. no, they...
Or like, do you want your iPhone still?
Right, exactly.
Oh, you want an iPhone? Okay.
Yeah, you want me to pay this bill?
Oh, I need something raked over there. I need something planted.
But, you know, the beautiful thing is... this is the way that they've been eating and kind of growing up. And,
right.
But, you know.
So, hold on. So, are they allowed to eat, have like a pizza or a burger or something?
Yeah, so the thing is, they're teenagers. And we're also, as much as we live this life, we're still free spirits. You know,
okay.
at the root of it, my husband and I. So, we don't put restrictions on them. You can't do this. You can't do that. We just
wow.
show them this is the way, right?
Right.
But they still eat chips, man. They still
yeah.
want ice cream when the ice cream truck comes down the
right,
street.
Right, right.
But I will say, when I first made those kale chips, they fell in love, and it was like, you know, we put them out online and they really blew up, and I'm just so thankful for like Instagram and the community.
Yeah,
but
yeah.
it took us like 6 weeks to catch up on our orders. I had to hire someone.
Yeah,
it was nuts, and they couldn't eat any, and they were going crazy. We just want kale chips. And so we finally caught up on our orders and they can eat them again. But I'm just thankful that, you know,
right.
they love, you know.
Well, when I come out to the farm, I want to try everything.
Yes.
I want to try everything. I want to see everything, have the whole experience, the tour and everything.
Exactly. Now, we got to get you in the summer when everything is
there. You
popping.
Go. There yeah. you go. So, one question before I play the next one, because it's called I Get Up. And there must be mornings, right? Because I know with the weather and stuff, I've seen you mid-winter again coming to do the markets or whatever.
Yeah.
And you're like, man, it was tough this morning. I had to get up. I had to take care of stuff even before I started packing and stuff. So, how do you stay motivated, you know, with New Jersey weather being what it is? Sometimes it's sweltering hot, sometimes
right.
it's freezing cold, you know, and you've got a lot to do for the day. Like, how do you and your husband stay motivated to, like, get up and get stuff done?
So my husband is definitely, you know, let's see, he's an Aquarius, which is an air sign, but he's fire, man. He is fire. So he wakes up, okay, 4:30, like, ready to go. You know, he doesn't sleep much, he doesn't sleep hard. He's just very motivated. That's his energy. He's like a battery, just doesn't stop.
Wow.
And so, you know, I definitely have my mornings where I'm struggling. That alarm goes off. I still need an alarm, you know.
Same as me. I need like 15 alarms. What are you talking about?
I need to snooze a couple times. So he definitely inspires me. I'll say that nicely.
Right. Okay.
Right. Put some music on, you know, and gets the vibe going.
Get the motivation
yeah.
going, and he motivates you too. Okay, well, I'll play this one. It's by the Teskey brothers. I don't know if you ever heard of them before.
Mm-hmm.
They're from Australia. They're a blues rock band, actually. But I feel like they really sound like kind of Otis Redding kind of feel. They got that real raw, soulful feeling. Teskey brothers, I Get Up. Check it out. LoveSoulRadio.net, DJ Benny James Podcast.
Sometimes trying to just get back. When you get broken down again, it ain't because you didn't try. I try to count the days that I've been disappointed. So many hard times it gets you joining. But it's hard trying to make a living when you and get down again, and you just keep giving. Every time I get up, something come and bring me down. I get so low sometimes, feel our love won't be the ground. Yeah. I tried my best to make my way, but it wasn't enough. Desire burns when your dreams are close to dust. I'm working for the man till it is done, but the hardest part starting from the start, but it's hard trying to make a living. Oh, when you get down again, and you just keep giving, giving away everything, giving away everything, giving away everything. Yeah. Every time I get up, I get up.
They started out formed in Melbourne, Australia. I love this band, man. Funny, when I first heard this band, me and my wife were going through the album right here, and we have one of those moments, man, that only married people can understand. She was dancing around to every song. I was looking at her, I was like, man, this woman is beautiful, such a good heart. You met my wifey, you know.
I love Faye.
You know the score. How can you not be in love with that? Anyway, we're going to move on to some Black Star hip-hop, which you chose.
Yes.
Thieves in the Night. Wow. I love Black Star. I never really focused on this track. I never really listened to the words, paid attention. Now I did, because of you.
Yeah.
Thank you. So we're going to play that. And then after this, I've got an important question for you to ask you. And I didn't really know how to pose the question. Like, conflicted. So stay tuned, and then I'll ask you right after this.
Yo, D, what? Come on, what? Come on.
Give me the fortune, keep the fame, said my man Lewis. I agreed, know what he mean, because we live the truest lie. I asked him why we follow the law of the bluest eye. He looked at me, he thought about it, was like I'm clueless. Why? The question was rhetorical, the answer is horrible. Our morals are out of place, I got a lot full of sorrow. And so tomorrow coming later than usual, waiting on someone to pity us. While we find the beauty in the hideous, they say money's the root of all evil, but I can't tell, you know what I mean? Pesos, franc shens, cowrie shells, dollar bills. Or is it the mind state that's ill, creating crime rates to fill the new prisons they build? Over money and religion, there's more blood that spills. The wounds of slaves and cotton fields that never heal. What's the deal? A lot of cats who buy records are straight broke, but my language universal, they be reciting my quotes while R&B singers hit bad notes. We rock the boat of thought that my man Lewis statements just provoke. Caught up in conversations of our personal worth, brought up through endangered species status on the planet Earth. Survival tactics means busting gaps to prove you hard. Your firearms are too short to box with God. Without faith, all of that is illusionary. Raise my son, no vindication of manhood necessary.
Not strong,
only aggressive,
not free,
we only licensed,
not compassionate, only polite.
Now who the nicest?
Not good, but well behaved.
Chasing after death so we could call ourselves brave.
Still living like mental slaves, hiding like thieves in the night from life. Illusions of oasis making you look twice. Hiding like thieves in the night from life. Illusions of oasis making you look twice. I'm sure that everybody out listening agree that everything you see ain't really how it be. A lot of jokers out running in place, chasing the style. Be a lot going on beneath the empty smile. Most cats in my area be loving a hysteria. Synthesized surface conceals the interior. America, land of opportunity, mirages and camouflages more than usually. Speaking loudly, saying nothing, you confusing me, you losing me. Your game is twisted, want me enlisted, and you use. Foolishly, most men join the ranks cluelessly, but foolishly accept the deception, believe the perception. Reflection rarely seen across the surface of the looking glass. Walking the street, wondering who they be looking past. Looking gas with them imported designer shades on. Stars shine bright, but the light rarely stays on. Same song, just remix, different arrangement. Put you on the yacht, but they won't call it a slave ship. Strangeness, you don't control this, you barely hold this. Screaming brand new, when they just sanitize the old shit. Supposes, just another clever Jedi mind trick that they've been running across stars through all the time. But I find it's distressing, there's never no in between. We either the good and the kings, we either the strips or queens. The deadly ritual seems immersed in the perverse, full of short attention spans, short tempers and short skirts. Long barrel automatics released in short bursts. The length of black life is treated with short worth. Get yours first, then I'm sick in the secondary. That type of illin that be filling up the cemetery. This life is temporary, but the soul is eternal. Separate the real from the lie, let me learn. You're not sure, I'm only aggressive, cause the power ain't directed. That's why we are subjected to the will of the oppressive. Not free, we only licensed, not lie. We just exciting, cause the captives own the masters to what we write. Not compassionate, only polite. We well trained, our sincerity's rehearsed and staged. It's just a game, not good, but we'll behave, cause the camera survey most of the things that we think, do, or say. We chasing after depth just to call ourselves brave, but every day next man meet with the grave.
give a damn if any fan recall my legacy. I'm trying to live life in the sight of God's memory like that, y'all.
Wow. Crazy.
Can I say something about that
Absolutely.
Song?
I was going to ask you why you choose this one.
So, that song is inspired by Toni Morrison, The Bluest Eye. So if you listen to the beginning of the song, Talib Kweli's verse, he references The Bluest Eye. He just kind of puts it in there. Yeah. But there's a whole passage within Toni Morrison's The Bluest Eye that the chorus where he says, not strong, only aggressive, not free, we only licensed, not like that. That's a quote from The Bluest Eye, and they just like turned it into hip hop. Like, absolutely amazing. That blew my mind when I was in college. Like, Black Star, that album came out, I think, my sophomore year of college at Howard University, because, you know, I had to shout that out.
That's all good. That's all good.
About the Howard thing. But,
I did a reunion party for them once.
Oh, yeah, nice.
That was
nice.
Fun.
But this album just blew me away. You know, I've been a hip-hop fan my whole life. But at that time, it was when it was getting real commercial and East Coast and West Coast. Yeah. And this album came out, and it was like, oh, man. Me in my dorm room just, yeah.
Same, like a breath of fresh air,
yeah,
right?
Oh,
game
man.
Changer.
And this song in particular, and I was like, wait a minute, you know. Let me go to my book and hold on. Blew me away. These guys, Mos Def.
And I've been looking out, man. I've been hearing rumors the last couple of years that they're working on another project. Apparently, they finished an album, but they shelved the album. It's not going to be released. It was canceled, apparently, because they're really upset about people just trying to get into their business and trying to get a piece of the pie.
Yeah.
And just that culture.
Right.
And they feel like this is unfair. These people, they've never written a rhyme in their life, never made a beat in their life, but they want a big piece of the pie. And you know, you heard this before from different artists, right? Saying that, you know, the industry, they don't take care of the artists, you know. And they got to do what they got to do. I understand that, I respect that, you know. But boy, would it be good to have another Black Star album. But he said, man, it might not come out until they're both well gone. So but he's gonna be working on a solo project.
Okay.
Talib, so look forward to that, man. I love Talib.
Yeah.
And Mos Def too, man. And they're both dope.
Absolutely.
So the question I was going to ask you, let me play this background here. So the question I was going to ask you, which is, you know, it's funny because I wrote this down, and when I wrote it down, it felt okay. And then I read it back, I'm like, you know what, I don't feel comfortable with this, and for many reasons. And I even called one of my friends about it, and I'm like, should I even ask this? And is it even necessary? Even in culture, is it even necessary to ask this question? And I keep getting this answer back in my head, yes it is, and no it's not. So I wanted to talk to you about it real quick. And it's about, the question basically was that, as black farmers, do you get recognized differently? Do you come across stumbling blocks? Do you do people look at you in shock? You know, or is it beneficial to you? And then I asked myself, why am I even asking? What does colors do anything, right? This show is about green, as far as I'm concerned. Right. It's about green, right? It's about plants, and it's about money. It's about, you know, how to make a living through something you love, growing stuff, which is green. So the show is about green. However, you know, you and your partner, you're black, and you're doing something that I don't see normally black people doing. So it could be an inspiration for other black people to grow their own stuff.
Yeah.
And I see this sometimes when I'm looking at posts. I'm like, the first black woman to invent whatever, or the first black man to, and I think to myself, why can't it just be like the first woman to invent? Or, you know, and I watched this thing on with Morgan Freeman once said, you know, the sooner we stop mentioning color, the sooner racism will end, because we're always putting a label on, you know, somebody's color. So I just thought I'd open up to you and just be honest to you, because I didn't have an answer, and I wanted to have a discussion with you really about it, about your thoughts about it and your experiences with it. And I don't know, just open up the discussion with you, really.
Yeah, no, man, I think it is relevant. But I agree with the statement that Morgan Freeman made. You know, it is in the way, and it's a, you know, human construct anyway. So what is race? And we can get into that philosophical conversation. But, you know, we can't deny the past and our experiences and history. So the question's important, because you don't see a lot of black people doing farming, especially in this country. And it has to do with, again, our disconnection to food, right? So we don't even see farming as a a job. When we talk to kids, especially in the city, even in the suburbs, people don't have a connection to food. You ask right. where food comes from, they say the grocery store.
Right. I saw a documentary once where these kids were going around a farm and they were looking at stuff coming out of the ground and they didn't even know what it was
right.
or that it even came from the ground.
Yes.
Like you said, that disconnect.
It's
just
a disconnect. And then you have to couple that. So that's across the board.
Right.
That's white, black, brown. Right. Everyone, right. especially in our society, just doesn't have a connection to our food. But then black people in this country, we have a traumatic past that's tied to agriculture. We right. were forced to work this land
right.
for no pay, treated unfair, you know, the whole atrocity of slavery brought here against our will, everything. So as soon as we could, we left the plantation physically and mentally, came up north, you know, and got jobs in factories and said, that's it, I'm not going back outside. So there's even in the black community, parents will chastise their children for getting dirty. Why are you planting that dirt?
Get out the dirt,
you know? And so that's just the way that, again, as a culture, we've kind of grown up, and especially now, you know, because we are, you know, technology, we're all indoors. We don't have to, you know, go outside as much. So we're just so disconnected. So I think it is important, you know, to highlight that we are black farmers. And, you know, in this country, there's, you know, we're only like 1%. I think we're up to 2% now of farmers in this country are black farmers.
1% or 2%?
Yeah.
Right.
And so, and then the average age of a farmer is 60 years old. So for us, and I mean, you know, I'm 40 now, so yeah. I don't feel young,
right.
but I'm still considered a young farmer
yes.
as a farmer. So I think it is inspirational. It shows an example that you can grow food and you can do this. And again, we aren't, you know, we don't look like typical farmers.
Yes.
So when we talk to kids, it's always, we look, I guess, cool yeah, or whatever you want.
Of course. Of course you do. You look cool, man. You both look cool. Let's just say what it is. Call a baby in his name. Yeah. Okay.
So it can be, you know, definitely inspirational for young people, again, to see farming as an option,
right,
or at least to have a better connection to their farmer and like respect what farmers do, which
right,
is to grow our
right.
food.
And I also brought up a statistic here. Well, not statistic, but just a statement here from Google saying overall black, Hispanic and Asian adults, these are non-elderly, are more likely than whites to suffer health issues like asthma, diabetes, and more and more and more heart conditions and everything
right.
else. So that's about food intake, right?
Absolutely.
And that's about impoverished areas
right.
having a liquor store, a gun store, and then a fast food place.
Fast food.
And then a liquor store, a gun store.
Yeah.
And it's set up that way.
It absolutely
right? it's set
is.
Up that way, right?
So even, you know, when you go to the corner stores, because for one, you don't have Whole Foods in those communities. You don't even have Wegmans in those communities.
Right.
So within walking distance, you know, in a lot of inner cities, this is across the country, you have corner stores. Corner stores got packaged food. So aside from like the fast food places, just I'm going to buy groceries. There's very little produce, fresh produce. And if there is any, it's, you know, it's not organic and it's usually very low quality. So they've shown that when the produce delivery makes their stop, they go to the hood last. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
So, you know, the access isn't there. But then there's education.
Right.
Because Micaiah used to do farmers markets at 52nd and Haverford in Philly, and folks will come through. But if they don't know what's on your table, if they have no interest, I hear people say, oh, I don't eat vegetables. I go, excuse me, what? How do you not? Just a whole class of food. Just
right.
I don't eat vegetables. But you need vegetables.
Like, I don't need water. I'm good.
Right. So that's, you know, so again, it's education that this food is, you know, what food is intended to be. And again, regardless of what we eat, if we're plant-based or not, we just got to get back to eating like actual food and less processed food, packaged food.
Yeah.
You know what I mean?
I mean, I believe I watched a couple of things like Food Inc.,
mm-hmm.
Forks Over Knives.
Right.
You guys pay attention to this now. You can write this down. Another one called Cowspiracy. I don't know if you saw that.
I haven't seen that.
Watch it. And it was amazing. It's basically about how agriculture these days has changed so much, and the whole land, about getting rid of acres and acres and acres of trees, and then
yeah.
how it depletes the land.
Mm-hmm.
And how the land ends up getting so fragile that it just runs into the sea, and there's no substance to the earth anymore. And it's crazy, man. So
yeah.
like some of these documentaries are so revealing. You know, it makes me feel like, man, I need to just eat better and just do better. And
yeah, it's about the environment too, you know, and that kind of comes through more of my like academic studies, but just learning how harmful agriculture is on the environment, which doesn't make sense because you think growing food should.
But it's the way it's done. They were explaining this. They were saying like in the old days, you know, it was really good for the environment. But now they say we worry about the carbon, you know, from the cars and all the rest of it. They said that's only minute compared to agriculture. And people don't know about that.
No.
So I found it really interesting. But we're going to talk. Actually, I want to talk to you a little bit about global warming right after this one. This is one of your choices.
Oh, yeah.
Why did you choose this one?
Oh, man. Just, you know, Bob Marley, period. But this song is just it goes right here, you know, it goes right to the heart. It's just beautiful. I love his voice in this song.
Yeah, it's called Forever Loving Ja. Bob Marley and the Wailers, wicked. It's funny, you know, when you're hearing the radio, right, you hear the, like the same 5-6 songs from Bob Marley, right?
Right, right.
You never hear these like B-side tracks.
So many.
It's criminal, right?
I know.
He's got such a body of work. It's just crazy.
Yeah, I kind of divided pre-Peter Tosh and post-Peter Tosh because, you know, yeah, that was a whole vibe.
Yeah. Tell us about the whole yoga thing. When did you get into that? And how does that, I've been hearing it a lot about how it can really affect your core, your body, your spirit, your mindset. Tell us a little bit about yoga, because some people think, oh, what is yoga?
Yeah, I know. So, all right, yoga, let's see. I first took a yoga class when I was in college, just at a gym, you know, kind of like just exercise. And I liked it, but it wasn't until I moved to Atlanta and I started taking a class they offered at Georgia Tech, just like a sort of, you know, extracurricular class type of thing. And the teacher, he just like really went deep. I was like, whoa, this is more than just exercise. But again, I was a broke graduate student. It's amazing how not having money, you know, like opens so many doors. So there was a free yoga class at the Hindu Temple of Atlanta every Sunday. And I used to drive down there because it was free. But little did I know, you know, I met my teacher and I studied there for many years, about 3-4 years. And I was, again, in graduate school, so high stress. I was at Georgia Tech doing field work, working in the lab, writing my dissertation. And, you know, that weekly yoga just helped to keep me grounded. And again, it was definitely for health and getting more flexible and all the benefits to your body, not just getting more flexible. That's what people see, you know,
right.
People doing splits. But no, it's your thyroid gland functioning properly. Mm. It's your digestive system and doing the twisting postures, yeah. And how, you know, it's funny. We used to be in yoga class and at the temple, it would be a lot of older people and they'd be farting. And I would bring my friends and we'd be in there, like, you know, giggling. We're like 23 years old. But, you know, you kind of understand, like, now you're unlocking some stuff. You're supposed to,
right,
you know.
Right. It's like I go to my chiropractor and I'm saying, like, obviously everything in your body is connected, right? So yeah. If you press a certain part, it's going to affect different parts of your body you don't even realize.
Right.
You know, it's so funny. So, like you say, he was saying that even it can infect, like, your digestion system and everything. Like,
yes.
If you're out of line, everything. So, same with yoga.
Same with yoga, absolutely. So, I was seeing the physical benefits. When I was growing up, you know, I was a little overweight. I was active, but... You know, I started going to the gym because I wanted to lose weight. And then it became more of a just living healthy lifestyle kind of thing. And so, you know, the yoga's kind of been there through that. But, you know, I did yoga through my pregnancies, through, you know, all three pregnancies.
Okay.
I had two home births. So just kind of preparing my body and more mind for that. Mm. I mean, it's definitely a physical thing. You know, it's painful. But... It's when you tap in mentally and you breathe, you know, and you know, Lamaze and all that. It's really just about your breathing. And so that's been, you know, amazing just to keep that through my life. So even now, super busy working, you know, I feel like I have 10 different jobs, but I wake up every day and meditate for several minutes and just make sure I'm grounded before, you know, I start checking email and DMs and all that.
So do you do official classes still? I've seen stuff online sometimes. I see you, like, in one of poses. I didn't know if you actually do classes or not.
Yeah. So I do classes. I started teaching virtually, you know, last year because of
COVID,
pandemic. Yeah. But we're going to open back up on the farm. Once it gets a little warmer, it's a little uncomfortable to do yoga and you know, and it's chilly, but definitely, by the summer, we'll have classes on the farm again.
But for now, if anybody's listening and they want to join your class,
anywhere.
how can they get in touch with you if they want to join your class?
So if you go to our Instagram page, Free Haven Farms, and you click the link in our bio, you'll see yoga classes there. And then my page too, my personal page. I should shout myself out, Dr. Cynthia Hall.
Well, why not? Why not give yourself a plug?
Yeah, and I've got a link in my bio as well for yoga classes. So every Sunday at on Zoom, you know, that's our new life now,
our
new platform.
Yeah.
But I do yoga every Sunday through that. So you can definitely join in.
Right, okay. Yeah. Well, there you go. You heard it here first. All right, we're going to go to two songs that I picked, which I think are appropriate for growing things. One is called Sunshine and one is called Rain. So let's play the Sunshine first. And this one is dope. Kind of got that old school funk 70s kind of flavor. Thanks for joining us, guys. We're already 75 minutes. Wow. Goes quick.
Just give me the sunshine. All I want is some sunshine. The sun to come along and twist the clouds away. Now I don't mind when it rains, cause everything needs it. When I'm with my baby in the park, I wish it would rain. Waiting for the sunshine. Let me have the sunshine. I love the sunshine. Just want some sunshine, yeah. Wait a minute, do you remember last winter when the snow took all the fun away? Yeah. It stayed cold, so cold for many a day. It took the sun to come along and bring the pretty weather. I don't know about you, but I know I'd like it better if you give me the sunshine. Give me plenty of sunshine. Let me have the sunshine.
How good is that?
That was perfect.
SWV, Sisters with Voices. A lot of people don't know that, what that means, SWV. Love that one, Oh Rain. I wish they would have done a few more like non-commercial tracks, right?
No, I really love
so,
SWV.
So talented, man. Coco's voice is just like crazy. On Instagram right now, there's a craze with this where the guys are singing this.
Yes, have you seen I've heard that. Yes,
that's
funny.
I'm having a lot of fun, man. Sometimes I just like just go somewhere, like I told you. I want to talk to you real quick about the weather as we were talking about sunshine and rain. How much does that affect what you're doing? Obviously, it must, right?
Oh,
with,
yeah.
with the growing.
Like, oh, man, it's all connected. Yeah.
How do you deal with that?
It's funny. You know, Micaiah always says that he has to be a farmer, but you got to be a meteorologist. You have to be an astronomer. You have to be a carpenter, a plumber. You know, you have to do everything. But we definitely right. have to keep up with the weather. And when it rains, like you said, the farmer's market, people might not come out because they don't like to walk around in the rain, and it'll totally mess up your whole Saturday and all the sales you were thinking of making. But you know, kind of getting away from that model because it wasn't that successful. It was so unpredictable, like the weather. But just the everyday, like you said, you wake up one day and it's cold and you still have to go outside and do the work. So, you know, just being prepared, you know, having a toolbox, you know. Mm-hmm. So we got the rain gear and we got snow gear, you got boots and you got, you know, tank tops, and you just stay ready. And being a geoscientist, I did a lot of field work. So I've been outside for a long time, even before the farming. So
yeah.
I'm kind of used to just dealing with the elements. And, you know, I appreciate the seasons. You know, I'm from Jersey. So
right. Yeah, my wife does too. Like, I want to go back to Hawaii where it's like 85 and you got the sea breeze all year round.
Right.
Like, I want to go back to Hawaii. She's like, I want to live here where the seasons. I'm like, you crazy?
Yeah, I don't know about that one. I'll take Hawaii over Jersey.
I know, she's crazy. What can I tell you? You know what this is in the background? You recognize it?
I do.
I'm curious. It's called Green Onions because we're growing things today.
That's
by Booker T and the MGs. I saw Booker T in Hawaii playing live a little while back. That was cool. But I'm going to move on to some Aretha Franklin because it was her birthday a couple days ago.
Love Riri.
Ah, Riri. And wow, what a legend. And this one that she sung, I don't think I played it before. It's called Every Natural Thing. So I thought that would be appropriate for today. So happy birthday and rest in glorious peace, Aretha Franklin. She died in 2018, man. We're running out of time. We only got 10 minutes left. Well, actually 8 minutes left. So I've got to ask you a couple more questions before we get out of here. But actually, I just saw something on Aretha Franklin where she did a live performance at a last minute. She didn't even plan it for Pavarotti. He was actually sick. You know, the famous operatic singer. He was sick. His voice was gone. And backstage was Aretha Franklin. And she said, I think I can sing that.
No way.
Yeah, and she sung it, and people have said that that's one of the best performances she ever did. So
the queen.
The queen. So check that out on YouTube. You can find that one. Very, very amazing. So let me ask you a little bit about global warming. Obviously, some people out there think that this is all a hoax and this is crazy. And the scientists, like yourself, talk about that a little bit. Does it affect what you do? Or have you seen the changes throughout your life? And what studies have you done?
Oh, yeah, definitely. I mean, if you haven't noticed, you know, we kind of rebranded it climate change because people will argue it's, you know, not getting warmer here. It's getting, so we say climate change to be more inclusive of the changes in the climate. But if you're an adult that's at least 20 years old, you've noticed the climate has changed where you live since you were a kid. And certainly for us. So definitely on a practical level, you know, things are different. But scientifically, yeah. I mean, doing studies that look at carbon dioxide, that look at nitrogen, the harmful effects of climate change on sea level rise and how that affects island communities. You know, we're seeing that. And of course, the melting glaciers. And my advisor, you know, did studies in Antarctica. And so he's been down there several times and just talking with him about how it's changed even in the last 20 years. And that's nothing on this human journey. So the fact that we're seeing these changes so quickly is scary.
Yeah, it is scary. Yeah, I've been seeing a lot of little documentaries about the glaciers. They take photos, right, of a few years ago, and then the photos of today, and you're like, it's pretty obvious.
Yeah, I went to Alaska a couple years ago on one of the you know, research vessels for an expedition, and we got to hike a glacier, and they have marks of where the glacier was at different years.
Right.
So you start back, and this is where it was back in 1873, and then you just keep walking, and then you see where the glacier is now, and you've walked, you know, a whole mile.
So for people in England, this is a stupid joke, but for people in in England, where the summer is on a Tuesday, right? And year after year after year, we just have rain and rain and rain. It never changes, right? So those people are like, how can you explain this? It's always crappy here. Like Seattle is always crappy. But like you say, there's certain pockets, right? It's going to pretty much maintain the same. But you look at the big picture.
Absolutely, yeah. Global temperature has
global.
Been, yeah,
okay,
rises.
Okay. You got that, guys? Global. It's global. It's not like local. All right, we're going to go back to a little bit of hip-hop here. I want to sneak this in before we get out of here. I've got a couple more for you. But I want to sneak this in because this is Phife Dawg, and I like Phife Dawg. I don't know if you like Phife Dawg.
Love him.
But he did this track a long time ago, and I never even knew about this track. First of all, Nutshell, because I just totally missed this song. And not only did I miss it, but they brought out a remix of it last month, which I just didn't even know about either. And that features Busta Rhymes and Redman, and both of those are like incredible hip-hop artists. So I'm going to play this and, wow, enjoy this one. It's called Nutshell.
Uh-huh.
Yeah. Yeah. Hey, yo, Bus, let me get a bus. Yo, Phife Dawg is in the building. Uh-huh. Red Man is in the building. Busta Rhymes in the building.
Remix.
Peep the rebirth of the reborn as I rebuild. Reconnect with this rebel, redefining raw skill. I realign, readjusted, refocus, reanalyze what's real. First, had to refuel, reactivate, to reemerge, reevaluate, recalculate, I return. Redefine, reenergize, get reacquainted. Rhythm Kins Incorporated, roots, we made it. Invulnerable, inviting, invincible, inventive one. Which leads most inviolable. Get involved, invest in these youths, kid, invigorate, induce that. That old realness, insecure, nah, more like inhumane, it's not a game, shut your mouth, use your inner voice, stay in your lane, inaugurate, those with incentive to want to innovate, insisting that those who inspire, we will initiate, what, and that's just me in a nutshell, 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 ha, Phife Dawg in a nutshell, New York finest in a nutshell.
Look. Unpredictable, I'm so unaffordable, unfathomable, the love I get unconditional, unequivocal, indestructible, unthinkable, spit is understandable, how to flow unforgettable, unbuckle belts, unclothed, description Rari's, unclean lines, gonna please go, clean up, unhospitable, thus one sick individual, untraceable DNA, wicked flow unforgivable, and that's just me in a nutshell, I unallow those unwelcome, you're unapparent, it's undisputed, I got you stuck like under a magnet, under a cabinet, unofficially though I had to get a number. Write it up under the logo with a laminate. The unbeaten, undertaker, undercut, and the unexplainable. Town heating, underhand, sticking it. Undenounced, bury you under the mansion. I undespeakably hope that we have an understanding. Ha, and that's just me in a nutshell. Nutshell, nutshell, nutshell.
Zen, bust a bus in a nutshell.
Yeah.
Here's Reggie.
Yeah. I keep moving, I keep bud, I keep fire. I keep an attitude, zigging, to keep trying. I keep it deuces, big. The Rob Schneider, I keep it flowing till my hands getting arthritis. I keep bars, I keep money, I keep cooking. I keep a car for Sharday to keep looking. I keep it jurors, I'm killing them. I keep going, I put you on a t-shirt and keep calm. I keep women, I'm like Nas, I keep ether. Phife and Bust, that's my brothers. Keeper, keeper, I keep a K, call it Slay, the street sweeper. Same Seamer, give me them keys to your Beamer. Keep your friends closer, enemies closer. It's rappers like me that are sent off Oprah. Keep focused. I keep blunts for cheap thrills. Me and Lizzie Lohan, that's a nutshell. Ha! Red Man in a nutshell. Nutshell.
Wow. Phife Dawg in a nutshell.
That's just me in a nutshell.
Busta Bus in a nutshell. And Red Man in a nutshell.
Phife Dawg in a nutshell. New York finest in a nutshell.
Wow. I like that one.
Never heard that.
I know. I haven't heard it too. I downloaded it this morning. So, in a nutshell. I am so blessed that you came. Thank you so much for joining us.
Thank you again for having me. It's been a blast.
This book, I'm looking at this book right in front of me. Is it available online as well?
Yeah, it is. It's available on our website, on our store. Yeah, on the Shop to Buy page.
Oh, okay. So is it a digital copy as well?
No, just the hard copy.
So they can order it. Okay.
Yep.
Is there plans to make it a digital copy as well?
Yeah, we've been talking about that. You know, yeah, so we got to like go back to the publishing, but yeah.
Okay, okay. All right. So once again, if people want to find out more about you guys, what's the best place they can go to find out all the information?
Yeah, so if you go to our Instagram page and definitely follow us, Free Haven Farms, and from there, if you go to our bio, click the link, you'll see all the stuff that we offer. But you know, we definitely post a lot and give out a lot of information and, you know, keep the vibe going about growing food and being healthy on our page. So.
Right, and that's what I like, because no matter if somebody's listening to this in Spain, or I have a lot of people listening to this in Japan and South Africa and different places. So if they're listening to this, you can still go to the site and you can still learn a lot right
Absolutely.
There.
Absolutely.
Right? And you can join classes Absolutely. And all different types of stuff. So you don't have to be in New Jersey.
That's the beauty.
But if you are in New Jersey, come and pay us
come
a visit.
Through. Yes, come to the workshop.
That's right. And pay me a visit too. Anyway, I'm going to leave you with one more, which is the one you chose, which is by John Coltrane, one of the amazing jazz artists of all time. This is called Cedar's Song Flutes, is that correct?
Yes.
And why did you choose this one?
So my dad is a jazz musician. He's a drummer, not famous or anything, but, you know, did his thing locally and just kind of gigged around town. But, you know, he exposed us to jazz and just all kinds of music growing up. And so we heard so much Miles Davis, so much John Coltrane, Sarah Vaughan and everything. But John Coltrane is so amazing to me. And I really connected to his message, spiritual and everything. He's from, you know, Philly. Or lived in Philly for a while, so there's the connection there, and I played the flute growing up, all into college. Even I played my first year in college, and so that's in the name. There's no flute in the song, but you know, definitely a connection. But this song, which is on Giant Steps, I believe, is just a beautiful song. So love John Coltrane. Too many songs to choose from, but I chose this one.
So we're so good. But thanks very much for coming again. I appreciate it. I'm very honored. And like I said, next time I'm coming out to the farm and going to do it live right there.
Yeah, thanks for having me. I'm a big fan of the show, definitely.
Thank you very much. Yeah, appreciate it. And you guys have a safe weekend or safe week wherever you are, whatever you're doing. Be blessed. And thank you very much. Love you guys. Aloha.